dear students, now we will continue our next point, that is the different states of water. See, in the last lecture we have discussed about the sources of water, okay, surface water, ground water, and I given you homework also last time to read related to that points and write important points in your notebook. Maybe you all have completed that work. Okay, so today we will start with the next point, that is the different states of water. See, already we discussed before also, but one time we revise what are the different states of water. See, states of matter. There are the three states of matter, that is solid, liquid and gas. Okay, and some examples also before we discuss. Now, in this lesson, because this lesson is of water, so we have to see the three states of water. See, three states of water is same, solid, liquid and gas. But in this time, you have to write the examples related to water. See, ice is an example of water and it is in a solid state. Okay, when we will provide the heat. Okay, otherwise if this ice, if you will keep the outside, not in a freezer, then it will start melting. Then it will convert into water. Then water is in which state? Liquid state. Okay, and when this water, when you will provide the heat, means what, whenever you are providing the heat, then it will start boiling. And when water will start boil, then it will convert into steam. Steam means which state? Gas state. Okay. So do you understand this three? See, first ice, it is in a solid state. Okay. On heating, means just that ice, if you kept in a outside the freezer, it will start melting immediately. Why? Because in a freezer, the temperature is very less and the outside the freezer, the temperature is more. Means what? The heat is there. And because of that process, ice started melting, which it will convert into a water. Water is in a liquid state. And when you will provide the heat to that water, it will convert into a steam. So these three are examples of these three different states. See, example of water means ice in a solid state, water in a liquid state and steam, or you can say here water vapors also. Okay, water vapor means gaseous state. Okay, now see, a steam on a condensation process. Okay, when water vapor on condensation, on cooling, it will convert into a water droplets, means steam. After cooling, it converted into water droplets, means water. Again, this water, if you will keep in a freezer at 0 degree Celsius, water will convert into ice. Okay, so this is the continuous reversible process. Okay, ice, water, steam. Then steam on cooling, it convert into water. On cooling, it convert into ice. So these three are the examples of three states of water. What are the three states of water? Solid, liquid and gas. In solid, example ice. In liquid, example water. And in gaseous, example water vapor. See, most of the students are doing mistake here only. Read question properly. If they are asking the what are the three states of water, then okay, most of the students, they write the root solid, liquid and gas. But whenever they are writing the example, that time book in solid, water in liquid and oxygen in gas. But now here they not ask the states of matter. They ask the states of water. So examples also related to water only. So in solid, what will be the example? Ice. In liquid, what will be the example? Water. And in gaseous, water vapors, or you can write steam also. So these three examples of three states of water. Okay. Now the next point we will discuss, that is the evaporation of water. Now evaporation of water means what? It is a continued process. Every day it's happened, the evaporation. Okay, means what? See, the process of changing water into water vapor is called as the evaporation of water. But when the water is changed into water vapor on heating, okay, when we will provide the heat, then only water will convert into water vapors. And that process is known as the evaporation. See, during summer season, in the rainy season, now see nearby our school, okay, there is a lot of water. But in summer season, you will see water everywhere. No, why? Because that time the heat, the temperature is more and the evaporation process is occur very fast. And so whatever the water remains, that all water is evaporated. Okay, and see now in a rainy season our clothes, they are not dry quickly. Why? Because the evaporation process is very slow. Why slow? Because temperature is less. But in summer season, it dry quickly. Right? Because temperature is more. If temperature is more, evaporation process will be fast. If temperature is less, the process will be slow. Okay? So see, everything, whatever the things, whatever the changes surrounded us, behind that science is there. Okay? So for that, you have to observe it properly. Why this happened? See, means we were not thinking only. Now in the rainy season, the clothes are not dry quickly. Why? What is the reason behind that? How many students think like this? No. Why? Because that all the common things. It is regularly, we know that it is common. But behind that science is there. And this is the main thing. The evaporation process is slow. And because of that, clothes not dry quickly in the rainy season. But in summer season, that time temperature is more and the evaporation process is fast. Okay, so do you understand what is the meaning of evaporation? Evaporation, just remember, water convert into a steam or water vapor on heating, that process is known as a evaporation. Okay, now the next process is a transpiration. See, this is one new point for you. Now, transpiration means what? See, do you know about the photosynthesis? Okay, photosynthesis process, what? The plants, they make their food by oil with the help of sunlight, water, minerals. Okay, and the chlorophyll is already present in the leaf. And with the help of this, all the things, plants can prepare their food. But see, when the roots, now how they are getting the water? The root absorb water from soil. When root absorb water from soil, and then it provide to all the parts of the plant. Okay, how they are getting water? Root absorb water from soil, and they provide all the part of the plant. And whatever the water is needed for the photosynthesis process, they use that water. And remaining water, it is as it is. So transpiration means what? Remains water. See, water is released by plant into the air as a water vapor through stomata. This process is called as a transpiration. Means the remains water is released by leaf. Okay, by leaf means through stomata. Now, stomata present on the surface of leaves, that you know already. Through stomata, the excess of water. Now, excess of water means what? The extra water is released through stomata. Okay, extra water or whatever the water is present on that plant. That water is released through stomata, means it is evaporated like that only. This process is known as a transpiration. Do you understand what is meant by transpiration? Transpiration means what? See, the first plants absorb water from soil. Then through the stem and all, it provides to all the parts of the plants. And the excess of water release outside in the air through stomata. That process is known as a transpiration. See, now in the rainy season, if you will see the nearby you, all plants are green in color. Okay, why? Because the transpiration process is so slow. Means the water is not released outside in that amount, but in the summer season, everywhere what you see? See, that time these all the leaves, whatever the plants are here, that color is totally different. They dry on that time. Why? Because of this process, transpiration process. Means all sun rays, because of that, the evaporation process fast, means this water release outside fast. Okay? And the water vapor through stomata, this process is known as a transpiration. So today what we discuss? We discuss these three states of water, that is solid, liquid and gas. And examples, if the question will ask related to the water, then remember this point that example, ice, water and water vapor, or you can write steam also. Okay? Then evaporation process, the process of changing water into water vapor is called as a evaporation process. And transpiration means what? Water is released by plant into the air as a water vapor through stomata. This process is known as a transpiration. Okay? So related to this point, you read points. It is given in your textbook, and the remaining points we will continue in next lecture. Thank you.